Hey there, Bare Knuckle News fans. Susan Singari here with Harris Stevenson, who is fighting at BKFC 15 in his home state of Mississippi, and he is fired up. So, Harris, you were supposed to face another opponent. Tell us what happened.
About 2 weeks ago, my original opponent took a boxing match down in Florida, ended up getting a medical suspension, and so he had to drop the fight. Fortunately for me, Drew Lipton stepped up. Also, fortunately for me, my original contract weight was 165. Me and Drew agreed to 175 originally. Unfortunately, due to COVID, they started strict regulations down here as of Friday. And so they started shutting down a bunch of saunas. So me and Drew talked last night, actually, and we both agreed to fall on our walk-around weight. We're both about 180, 185, so we agreed to do 185, just kind of make it easier on each other, just make it a little bit, have fun. He weighed in at 184.8. I was 181.8, so we're good.
We are definitely looking forward to seeing that fight tomorrow night on the BKTV app or on Fight TV. How do you deal with a last-minute opponent change mentally? Because I know you're always ready physically, but so much of the fight is mental.
Absolutely. I mean, the biggest part about it for me is it's kind of a self versus self type of thing. And I think I'm really prepared against anybody who they put in front of me. It's just a matter of kind of finding the different advantages I'm going to have. Like, Drew's a shorter opponent. I've shown weaknesses fighting shorter opponents in the past, you know. I've kind of had the problem of squatting down, trying to reach their level and not standing tall, being my tall fighter self and keep my distance. I worked hard on that last 2 weeks because Drew is a lot shorter, so I have to keep my distance. And Drew does throw wild overhands, so I have to be cognizant of that and kind of keep my distance to keep from getting caught.
Speaking of wild overhands, let's take a look back at that fight with Kenny last year, because you did a really good job at it. And tell us specifically how you have improved as a fighter since last year when you fought him.
Last year when I fought Kenny, man, I was excited. I knew I had him hurt. I saw the blood. I saw the eye swelling. It's kind of like a shark in the water type thing, smelling blood. And I just kind of went to a frenzy. And I've worked very hard to keep my composure, be a little bit more patient. If I get Drew hurt, I'm not going to go in for the kill immediately. I'm going to back up. I'm going to pick my shots, take my angles, and I'm going to do all the proper steps to get Drew in and out of there at the right time. I'm not going to rush it.
Before we go today, Harris, is there anything else you'd like to add, sir?
I did get promoted to detective, so it's a whole new stream of work for me, a whole new different training schedule, so I've had to kind of alter that. But, I mean, with COVID, everybody had to alter, so, I mean, it's really nothing big. Just a matter of upping my cardio and being ready for anybody.
All right, combat sports fans, we will be there tomorrow night at BKFC 15, bringing you all the action and all the post-fight interviews.